strongly believe that life is too short to spend it doing something you don't want to do, trying to be or become someone who someone else expects to be. This is your life. I like to live my life prioritizing moments of pure joy, that overwhelming feeling that life is so good. For me, those moments don't involve money or things. Those moments involve hugging someone I love, learning new things, visiting new places, and looking for frogs in the wild.
Growing up, the strongest women I knew were my mom and my grandma. My mom raised me and my brother as a single mom, and she was working full-time as a middle school history teacher. And she loved her job. She had so much passion, and she transmitted that passion to her students, and she taught me to find a job doing the same, having pure joy and loving what I do. My mom told me and my brother that we could always do it, and my grandpa used to have this saying that there is only one way to go, up and forward. Most times we can't control what happens in life, but what we can control is how do we react to those things. So I actively decide to stay positive and believe in myself. And I don't let anyone tell me who I am and what I can or can't do. And I always try when I want something, because the worst that could happen is that I don't get it. But if I don't try, then the likelihood to get it is zero. So I normally try to achieve what I want. Well, I love doing field work. Looking for cool frogs in amazing places is my job, and I work really hard to get it, and I'm really fortunate to have it. My favorite are long expeditions to remote places. For example, I remember seeing the Milky Way from the first time laying in the back of a truck in the Mexican desert. And I remember walking this path in the forest in Ghana towards a swamp and hearing the loudest, most diverse chorus of frogs and thinking, if heaven exists, this must be the entrance. When I was doing fieldwork during college for my research thesis project, I saw the first tree frog in the wild. And it was so chubby and had huge eyes. And tree frogs have these special structures in their fingers that help them climb trees. So when I held it, I felt like it was so sticky and just wanted to hug me. So I was hooked. They also have these really crazy eyes, like they're trying to tell you a secret. And frogs have been around for millions of years, against all odds. So study them inspire me because they're so strong and resilient. I learned to be patient. In science, a lot of things fail before they work. For example, I have been in the forest for weeks without seeing any frog, and sometimes I need to repeat the same experiment in the lab hundreds of times. Writing a scientific manuscript is also challenging. It takes practice, and the publishing process is rough. So it's important to be patient for all these reasons. But it's also important to create a good teamwork environment and create better relationships with our friends.